Well, good morning, everybody. Welcome to this glorious day. The sun is out. The air is warm. And I'm looking into a lot of sunglasses out there, but not from my own. This is a long-awaited day, and we're so glad that you're here. So on behalf of the Board of Trustees, Biola University, I want to welcome you in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ to this dedication service for the Talbot School of Theology building in front of you and behind me. We're so delighted that we have members from the La Mirada City Council, including Biola alumnus Mayor Steve Jones, with us today, as well as City Manager Tom Robinson. This building behind me would not be complete were it not for the indefatigable effort of so many teams, and from especially the company of Millian Severson, our general contractor, and Rod McIsaac, the project manager. Certainly Gensler and Associates, our architects who are represented here today, as well as commercial sales who furnished the many furnishings inside the offices and the classrooms in this building. My colleague Greg Balsano, Vice President for University Services, has a team that worked very, very hard on every aspect of this building. At the same time, a parking structure was going on at the other side of campus. So Ken Bascom, Jody Spicer, thank you so much for your good work as well in this historic moment. We have leaders from other institutions that are here. We have pastors, church leaders. We have Talbot School of Theology alumni. If there are pastors, church leaders, Talbot alumni, if you're here, stand up so we can recognize you and welcome you, or welcome you back. This is also Biola Weekend. So we have parents here, we have alumni from the university, family and friends in attendance. For these next few days, lots of stuff going on. If you're a Biola weekend participant, alum of the school, or a parent, a family friend, why don't you stand up so we can welcome you as well this morning. It's great to see you Biola graduates and you mothers and fathers. We're gonna have a chance tomorrow to talk a little bit more. Far over there on my right up in the balcony, we have former trustee Hutz Fell, who will be sharing at lunch today, as well as Virginia Motes. Virginia, a longtime supporter of Biola University. I talked to Virginia last week and wished her happy birthday. It was her 99th. So Virginia, welcome. It's great to see you up there looking like Queen Victoria. Delighted to work alongside the incredible faculty and staff of Biola University, many of them represented here today. If you're a faculty staff member, why don't you stand as well? It's truly my honor to work among one of the best teams in higher education today with those individuals that have just stood, and how honored I am to be part of this community. And finally, we want to welcome our most special guests, and that are our students. So our students, wherever you are, why don't you stand up so we can recognize you. We love our students at Biola, and thanks for getting up early for this chapel service, outside style. It's going to be a little bit different today, and it may go a little bit longer. So if you have a class following chapel at 10:30, just stay seated, because your professors are probably here as well, so don't worry about it. Reflecting on the fundraising process that led to this moment, there is a story that's written inside this building. I invite you to read it later on about the miracle of May. 2010, when in 40 days, when this community gathered together to fast and pray, God showed up in ways that blew away our expectations, imaginations, and our preconceptions of what would happen. And as we needed to raise the final $6+ million towards this $18.2 million building behind me, we saw in those 40 days time and again, beyond our own realm of predictability, what God would do, so that when this building is up, we could not say what a great team we have, but what a great God we serve. So to God be the glory, great things he has done. We've seen donations come from literally all over the world, from Indonesia, from Taiwan, from Korea, from Hong Kong, from the Philippines, from Japan, from Canada, from Scotland, from 36 states within these United States, Washington, D.C., over 800 donors have given to this project. Their names are listed inside, but I think they're listed in the biblical way, and that is those who gave $50 next to those who gave $3 million, just alphabetical order right inside that building, because every donor to this project was obedient to what God called him or her to do, or the families, or the foundations, or corporations. So we are so grateful to those who have invested in this building. Many of you are here today. I want to welcome those who are watching the live streaming webcast from around the world that are joining us here on this bright and beautiful Southern California Friday morning. Talbot alumnus and radio personality Frank Pastore is here today. Frank will be recording a broadcast for his show, which is going to air at, I think, 4 o'clock today. So you might want to watch, and if you're not watching, listen, KKLA 99.5, the intersection of faith and culture. Is that right, Frank? You got it. And reason. Yeah. Faith and reason. Yeah. It might now be the intersection of faith and culture. Reasonably speaking. So today is October 14th, 2011. It's a historic day. It's a day of remembrance, day of thanksgiving, day of reflection, day of blessing that God has bestowed upon this university, now 103 years old. And as we dedicate this latest monument to God's faithfulness to Biola, I'd like to look back nearly a century to the original dedication ceremony with the cornerstone for that was laid at that very first building in downtown Los Angeles. It was May 31st, 1913. The fledgling community that for only 5 short years had existed as the Bible Institute of Los Angeles gathered together at that urban intersection of 6th and Hope Streets to listen to the founder, to the businessman, to the entrepreneur, to the visionary, Union Oil Company President Lyman Stewart. Recently, I was given a copy of his original typewritten manuscript with the notes prepared for that occasion nearly 100 years ago. Thank you, Professor Paul Rood, grandson of Biola's third president, Paul Rood, for your research into the life of Lyman Stewart and providing that document for me. And as I read through that cornerstone speech, I was struck by how much Lyman Stewart's words would be the same as my words today at this dedication, nearly 100 years later. Here's a brief section of what he said. These buildings are not to be a monument to any man, nor to any set of men, but are to ever stand solely for the promulgation of the eternal truths of God's holy word. Over its portals and running across the front of this central building will stand the inspired declaration, "Forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven." This divinely inspired word will be ever the source of truth, which will inspire all of the Institute's activities, furnishings. From its exhaustless resources, the instruction which is to enable the Institute to send forth Bible workers furnished completely unto every good work. A lot has changed, and a lot hasn't. It's heartening to read those words to you this morning and realize that they are still true for Biola today. This school is still inspired by the unchanging, divinely inspired, inerrant word of God. Our mission is still to send forth students furnished completely unto every good work, being confident of this one thing, that he who began a good work in this community is still going to bring it to completion until the day of Jesus Christ. A century has passed, a century in which many colleges have abandoned similar convictions, but to God's glory, Biola has remained steadfastly committed to a foundation grounded in the Word of God. Lyman Stewart went on to say that the eternal truths of God's holy word were going to be a part of this building, a sure foundation which can never be shaken, he said. And he wrote, upon this foundation has been building and will continue to build with the inspired assurance that its work shall abide. One of those windows behind me is a passage from John 15, I am the vine, you are the branches. And later on in that passage, you said, if you abide, if you remain in me and my words remain in you, you can ask whatever you want and it's going to be done. This school has been rock solid on abiding, remaining in the Word of God. And indeed, Biola stands today as ever on an unshakable foundation. This building, so stately and well-made, will physically last for generations, but its existence, its purpose, its eternal impact will come not from cement and not from steel, but from a much deeper foundation, the eternal truths of God's holy word and the work of the Spirit, which is the other window. That passage from Zechariah 4:6 where it says, it's not by might and it's not by power, but it's by my Spirit, says the Lord. My hope and my prayer is that 100 years from now, at a future dedication ceremony for whatever the latest building project would be, should the Lord tarry, the same commitments that Lyman Stewart spoke of, and that I'm speaking of today, will still be the bedrock, the foundation of this institution. To God be the glory, great things he has done. It's my honor to introduce our scripture reader today, Annabelle Cook. Annabelle, as you know, wife of longtime President Clyde Cook, served this institution for 25 years as its first lady. Mother, devoted wife, a grandmother whose grandson is a freshman at Biola University today, Kevin, sitting with his family and extended family in the front row here. Annabelle is going to read one of Clyde's life passages, a passage that I read from his Bible 42 months ago at his memorial service when we celebrated the long and lasting and godly and integrity-filled life of Clyde Cook. Please join me in welcoming our scripture reader, Mrs. Annabelle Cook.
This morning, a passage of scripture that I'll be reading is found in Isaiah 40, verses 3 to 8. A voice is calling, clear the way for the Lord in the wilderness, make smooth in the desert a highway for our God. Let every valley be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. And let the rough ground become a plain, and the rugged terrain a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord will be revealed, and all flesh will see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, call out. Then he answered, what shall I call out? All flesh is as grass, and all its loveliness is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades, when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God stands forever. Thank you.
Let us pray. Y ahora, Dios y Padre, deseamos agradecerte por el privilegio de portar por un momento la antorcha del testimonio de Cristo que alguna vez fuese llevada por grandes hombres, hombres que fueron grandes debido a que creyeron en tan grande Dios.
Lyman Stewart, Dr. R. A. Torrey, et T. C. Horton, et tous les autres qui étaient associés avec eux, hommes et femmes qui sont au ciel depuis de nombreuses années.
先に天に召された先達たちの尊い統治の主をどうして私たちのようなものを選んで託されたのか不思議に思います。この託された尊い日が今後もより明るく、より力強く燃え上がるように祈ります。
ونحن نسأل أن تشييد هذا المبنى في هذه الجامعة يبرهن أنه شهادة أعظم للرب يسوع المسيح أكثر من أي وقت عرفته بيولا.
求你为我们兴起更多的人，以致这善功能得以完成，并且是全然的完成，以致在世界历史黑暗的时刻，有一束耀眼的光芒可以从这个地方为主耶稣基督射出。
And now may the grace, mercy, and peace from the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rest and remain with us all, both now and forever. Amen. And at this time, we're pleased to play an original recording of this prayer spoken by this building's namesake, Louis Talbot, at the groundbreaking of Biola's La Mirada campus nearly 55 years ago in 1957.
And our God and Father, we want to thank thee for the privilege of holding for a little while the torch of testimony for Christ that was once held by such great men. Men who were great because they believed in a great God. Lyman Stewart and Dr. R.A. Torrey and Dr. T.C. Horton and all those others who were associated with them. Men and women who have been in heaven for many years. And we wonder just why about it choose us to hold the torch that passed from their hands when thou didst take them to heaven. We pray that this torch may grow brighter, burn brighter over the years. And we ask that the erection of these buildings on this campus may prove to be a greater testimony for the Lord Jesus Christ than Biola has ever known. Raise up many friends for us in order that this work may be done and done completely, so that in these tragic hours of the world's history, that there may be a blaze of light for the Lord Jesus Christ shining from this place. And now may the grace, mercy, and peace from the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit rest and remain with us all, both now and forever. Amen.
Jesus, walk with me. trials in my trouble walk home. I want Jesus to walk with me. I want Jesus in my trials. Lord, walk home. I want Jesus to walk home with me. When my heart, is almost breaking, oh my Lord,
Lord, I want Jesus.
Oh, help me, Jesus. Oh, help me, Jesus, Lord.
Lord, I want Jesus.
Oh, help me, Jesus. Oh, help me, Jesus, Lord.
Lord, I want Jesus.
Lord, help me, Jesus. Oh, help me, Jesus, Lord.
Talbot School of Theology is grounded in a rich heritage and steadfast commitment to serve the cause of Christ and equip new generations for the mission. This is Talbot's legacy. For the last half century, Talbot School of Theology has been committed to developing disciples of Jesus Christ. And as a new chapter begins with the opening of this new building, the legacy continues. At Talbot, students are challenged to let their thought processes, character, and lifestyle reflect those of our Lord. And they are equipped to carry on the work of making disciples. Talbot is a multiplying institution, equipping pastors, leaders, writers, teachers, and other influencers to go forward and equip others. What starts here expands elsewhere. This is Talbot's legacy. When Dr. Lewis Talbot first established an accredited theological seminary at Biola in 1952, with its first dean, Charles Feinberg, he likely could not have envisioned the scene before us today. But he would be thrilled to see the prominence of this building on this campus, one of the tallest on Biola's skyline. He would be humbled to see what God has done in and through Talbot, providing the foundation for an entire university as it has grown and weathered much change over the decades. He would give God the glory for this sacred space, this blessed ground on which thousands of souls have been grown and fed with the Word of God. He would give thanks as we do today for the fact that throughout the world, every day, millions of people are benefiting from the teaching and training of Talbot. In churches, in clinics, in schools, in boardrooms and beyond, the legacy of Talbot is felt throughout the world and is growing every year. Glory be to God.
Talbot School of Theology is grounded in community. Talbot is more than just a seminary, more than just a place to get a degree. It's a family. Talbot recognizes that growth does not happen in a vacuum, but through the relationship that shape us, spur us on, and build us up in faith. At Talbot, there's not a spirit of competition that defines much of the higher education today. Instead, there's a spirit of collaboration and community. Whether through AS activities, alumni networking, Mentoring or just a formal gathering of friends and small groups, building community is a priority to Talbot. Thriving community is a crucial piece of spiritual formation and thus an important part of Talbot missions. With the opening of this new building, new spaces will emerge where students and faculty will learn from one another, build each other up, and continue to grow as a community committed to impacting the world for Jesus Christ.
Please notice the banners as they roll down with each topic. Talbot School of Theology is grounded upon the Bible, the Word of God. Biblical scholarship is the center, the focal point, the driving engine of what Talbot is all about, and by extension, by what Biola University is all about. Talbot is the backbone of Biola University. In more ways than one, Talbot puts the B in Biola, providing the anchor which grounds the university in the unchanging word and keeps the university from being blown adrift by social and cultural trends. Throughout its history, Talbot has been committed to biblical scholarship that engages contemporary ideas from a decidedly evangelical perspective. The top-notch faculty here are committed to the inerrancy and therefore centrality of the Bible for all scholarship. And they are committed to the interdisciplinary relevance of the Bible for today's world. Whether aspiring scientists, journalists, CEOs, pastors, talk show hosts, Biola students have for generations benefited from the wisdom and insights of the Talbot faculty, who are widely published and influential throughout the evangelical world. Talbot's goal is to equip students to be integrative Christians, thinking biblically about all aspects of life. Throughout its history, Talbot has held firm to the faithful word, never backing down from its conviction that the Bible is not peripheral to the pursuit of knowledge, but absolutely central. Talbot remains committed to that conviction on this day in which we dedicate our new Talbot building. May God receive the glory.
Talbot School of Theology is grounded in a commitment to knowing truth through the study of Scripture and to allowing this truth to transform our lives and impact our communities. Transformation is one of the university's core values and purposes, to develop in its students a spiritual life in harmony with the great doctrines of the faith, so that we may grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. An emphasis on spiritual formation in this multidisciplinary curriculum produces godly leaders who are men and women of integrity, leaders who are intentional about their walk with God, both inside the classroom and outside the classroom. Around the world, Talbot graduates are engaged in practical Christian service, armed with missionary and evangelistic zeal and a dynamic knowledge of the Word of God. We're making a difference because we are different. Why? Because the professors at Talbot recognize that it's not enough to fill students' minds with facts and information. Students must be transformed. Romans 12 charges Christians to be transformed by the renewing of your mind, which is an intellectual and a spiritual process. Here, this is exactly what happens. Minds are renewed. lives are transformed. Hallelujah.
Talbot School of Theology is grounded in truth. At a time in history when truth is under attack, when postmodernism, pluralism, and deconstructionism all undermine truth in the academy, Talbot School of Theology continues to uphold truth as a central part of its educational mission. Talbot believes not only that truth exists, but that it is knowable, pursuable, and necessary for any productive inquiry into philosophy, theology, art, or science. Thus, for as long as Talbot has existed, it has anchored Biola University in the truth, guiding students in their pursuit of knowledge by centering them on the one who said, "I am the way, and the truth, and the life."
Talbot School of Theology is grounded in a commitment not only to truth and transformation, but also to having a strong testimony to share with the world. Since its founding, Talbot has been equipping servants of the gospel to take the good news to the world, testifying to Christ's work in their own lives and his saving grace for all creation. At Talbot, testimony is crucial because it's not just about what we teach or learn about truth inside the classroom. It's about how our lives speak to that truth and the manner in which we live in our families, our workplaces, our ministries, and our everyday living. For 6 decades, Talbot has been sending out graduates who aspire to live lives that testify to God's faithfulness and to the transforming impact of his grace. This new Talbot building is in itself a testimony to God's faithfulness in growing the school and expanding its impact for the cause of Christ. With over 1,100 students currently enrolled in Talbot's graduate programs in La Mirada, as well as students in Talbot's extension sites in Orange County, New York City, and Kiev, Ukraine, not to mention over 4,000 undergraduates taking Bible courses from Talbot faculty, the testimony of God's work through Talbot is growing. And with the opening of this new building, we'll only continue to grow. Amen.
All current students, both undergraduate and graduate, please rise. This new building will be a site of teaching, learning, and spiritual formation for students. Students enrolled at Talbot, but also every undergraduate student at Biola, who will take numerous courses in Bible and theology during their time here. The legacy of this building will be strong among generations of students. Tens of thousands of students will learn important lessons within these walls. They'll gain valuable insights in the offices of professor mentors. They'll have life-changing conversations or times of prayer in the rooftop garden. This will be a place from which world-changing disciples of Christ will be trained and sent out. And for the current and future students who will, within this building, grow in grace and knowledge, we now pray. Will you please join me in extending your arms in the direction of one of the students who is standing as we pray a prayer of dedication for them? O Lord, our Lord, how majestic is your name in all the earth. You have set your glory above the heavens. When I look at the heavens, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars, which you have set in place, what is man that you take thought of him, and the son of man that you care for him? Father, who are we that you should care for us? We who were your enemies, but have now been brought near because Christ died for us. By your grace, we are your children, and you have called us to be servants, servants of Christ, and servants to a world that desperately needs to know your truth, grace, and love. We come before you today to dedicate and bless these students for the work of ministry. May they know ever more deeply the gospel of your Son, Jesus Christ, and be filled with your Spirit to imitate Christ's example so that they may be a light to a dying world. May you fill them with the hope of your promises, zeal for your word, and a commitment to follow wherever you lead. Strengthen their hearts and renew their minds in your truth. Encourage them when the road is long and hard, and inspire them to be merciful, just, and loving. May they be submitted to the gentle leading of your Spirit, that they may seek not the things of this world, but the things of your kingdom, that they may be witnesses to the world and servants who glorify you. And we pray this in the name of your blessed Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Will all Talbot faculty please rise? Biblical faith is not allergic to the imagery of building. Paul recognized that there is one sure foundation and that sapient care must be taken by those who build upon it. Solomon, in his great dedicatory prayer of the temple in Jerusalem, recognized the importance of sacred physical space, even while he said there is no room, no building anywhere that could contain the living God. This building will be the place on our campus where biblical faith, an unremitting focus on biblical faith and the life hidden in Christ, will be studied and passed on from one generation of leaders to the next. Will you please join me in extending your arms in the direction of the faculty members standing near you as we pray a prayer of dedication for them?
With the dedication of this new building, Father, we recognize your blessing on us. And in turn, we dedicate ourselves to you, to our calling to serve you, and to serve your students. Father, I pray that these faculty are blessed with your love. Love for their students, love for each other, love for the pursuit of truth, and love for you, our Father. We dedicate them clothed with humility and ask that you grow that deeper and deeper each day, that we would take ourselves not seriously, but take our calling upon our lives as you have called us to serve your people. Clothe us with humility. And Father, we pray that you would give us vision, a clear vision of you, a clear vision of our Lord Jesus Christ, and a clear vision of the work of your Spirit in our lives as we see the vision to serve you on this campus and around the world. We dedicate our faculty to you, Father.
Heavenly Father, today with gratitude we celebrate the addition of the new Talbot East facility for its offices, classrooms, meeting spaces, and worship venues. Mindful that you alone, Lord, are the one who makes a space sacred, we dedicate today this new space on Biola's campus to the glory of your sacred name, that your work can be accomplished in this space by these faculty. Even apart from its provision of long-desired additional rooms for various educational and ministry endeavors with students, the addition of this new Talbot East building creates a new venue for the enjoyment of Christian community for these faculty colleagues at Talbot and Biola, especially those of the Department of Philosophy of Religion and Ethics and the Division of Biblical and Theological Studies, who've long been far-flung from one another across the university campus. So, Lord, for this, We give you thanks and ask that the community fostered within this new space will be a joyous testimony of community within your body, the church, throughout the world. And we pray that the legacy of Biola would continue within its walls with these people, that their biblical scholarship would hold forth your truth for the transformation of lives around the world, which is made possible only by the shed blood of Jesus our Lord, in whose name we pray these things. Amen.
And if you please be seated, Talbot faculty. In a few moments will occur the ribbon-cutting ceremony, but first a musical selection performed by the King's Men.
Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart. Not be all else to me, save that thou art. Thou my best thought, by day or by night. Waking or sleeping, thy presence my light. Be thou my vision, O Lord of my heart.
solid rock, which is printed in your bulletin program.
Settled in heaven. These words inscribed on the plaque dedicating this building express the convictions of our hearts. Your word is truth everlasting, and we declare those words boldly. Our prayer is that this truth would frame each intention, would give direction to all activities that are part of the people and the activities of this building, but of the School of Theology and Biola University as well. We have reason to give thanks beyond measure, dear God. But most profoundly and of greatest import today, we humbly and gratefully acknowledge your faithfulness to this community. These past 60 years of Talbot School of Theology, the 103 years of Biola University, you have been faithful. Jeremiah spoke of your steadfast devotion, your dependability. He spoke of it as loving kindness that is everlasting. Surely we have enjoyed your loving kindness in great abundance, and we thank you. The Apostle Paul described your goodness as grace that is lavished on your people. And so in response, we can do no other than to respond with renewed commitment to the things to which you have called us. We do so looking to you for direction. We cannot, we dare not assume our own capacities to plot the course. Guard us from fashioning in our own minds a vision for this structure that is anything more than what it is. and that is an instrument to accomplish your purposes for this place. May this never become symbolic of our own achievement. We give mind, heart, and will with renewed, with resolute commitment to obedience and faithfulness. And we do so in the strong name, the everlasting name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Well, thank you all for coming today. It's been a real joy having you here with us this morning. Those of you who have been invited to the Talbot Luncheon, please join us in the tent behind the Talbot Building, to my left, to your right. We encourage you to head over there by 11 o'clock this morning. We'd also like to invite our students and Biola weekend guests to enjoy lunch in the tent right behind you here on the Metzger Lawn. Lunch for you will be served at 11:30. As you exit this area, I encourage you to head out towards the bell tower. If you would like to tour the new Talbot Building, please go left at the bell tower and then come up on the opposite side of this building, Rose Hall, and we will gather at the east entrance of Talbot, and tours will begin in just a few moments. If you would rather tour the building at a later time, I encourage you to also head towards the bell tower and then turn to the right to enjoy Biola weekend festivities around the floor fountain. Again, thank you so much for celebrating with us this morning. To God be the glory. Great things he has done. Enjoy your day.